God didn't become important to us. That's the problem, brothers and sisters, in understanding. So we're going to talk about inshallah ta'ala, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, wa may yaqtul, and this is important for the young brothers and sisters, for the young brothers in particular that's committing all the crimes. If that's what you want to do, then you at least have the right to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about it. We can tell you it's wrong, we can tell you it's haram, we can tell you this, that, and that. But every last one of us, we're all Muslim in here, alhamdulillah. And if we're Muslim, that means we believe in the book of Allah. And if we're Muslim, that means we understand that the Quran is what we're going to die on. And if we agree to that, then you have to agree to the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where Allah says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا فَجَزَاؤُهُ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدًا فِيهَا وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَعْنَهُ وَعَذَّبَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, He says, the people that kill, مَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا, whoever kills a believer, whoever kills a believer, مُتَعَمِّدًا. And Allah makes a distinction here. Allah says, مُتَعَمِّدًا. مُتَعَمِّدًا means intentional. Not by accident. Not that you hit a brother by a car by mistake. You did something by mistake. You caused a person to die. That مُتَعَمِّدًا. Your intent was to take that person's life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَجَزَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمُ. Then his place is in the hellfire. خَالِدًا فِيهَا. Then Allah describes it. Allah says, خَالِدًا فِيهَا. Now one of the things we have to know as Muslims, خَالِدًا means forever. But if the person was a Muslim, it doesn't mean forever, like eternity means for a very long time. But here Allah says, خَالِدًا فِيهَا, for a very, very long time. And then Allah says on top of that, وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Then Allah says, being they earned Allah's anger. Now think about this, everybody. Every last one of us in here, we have somebody that we hate to be mad at us. Everybody. Everybody. Maybe it's your wife, maybe it's your husband, maybe it's your friend. Everybody has somebody in their life that they wish would ever be mad at. Everybody. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you do this crime, then you gain Allah's anger. So let's think about that. What does that look like? If your wife is mad at you, she might not cook for you. Your husband mad at you, you might talk crazy, whatever. Your man mad at you, your homie, you might fight, whatever the case may be. What happens when your Lord is angry with you? What does that look like? Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with us. How are we going to win that? We're still winning that. It's a hell. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa la'nahu. Not only is Allah angry with you, but then Allah curses you after that. Allah curses you after that. And then after that, Allah says, وَعَذَّبَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا. And then Allah says, and I prepare for that person a painful punishment.